Welcome to the Hidden Valley High School 2020 graduation ceremony. I am Ben Bickle and your guest speaker for today's commencement. Obviously, this is not a typical graduation nor a typical time in our society, but it is a great model for some of what I consider to be the most valid attributes in finding success: adaptation, flexibility, persistence, determination, fortitude, gratitude, and kindness. I know and completely understand that very few want to hear a long-winded guest speaker at their graduation, so I'll do my best to keep it short. I also know that we repetitively hear some of the same kitschly iconic catchphrase soundbites of advice, but in part due to their uncanny truth as a mantra for a successful life. 6/2/1982 was a graduation day for Hidden Valley High School. Granted, a much different one than today's. It was also the only graduation day at Hidden Valley that either of my parents missed in their 36 and 32 years that they taught here. You see, today is my birthday, marking 38 years of life. No, I am not 45 like many of you have suggested over the past 4 years. I know and I have a lot to still learn in life, and I make no false claims of knowing what it is all about. But there are some aspects of life I feel pretty confident in offering some advice on. You are graduating from a life of multiple choice and A, B, C, or D. 12 years of quizzes, tests, and school life's ups and downs. You have gone from learning the alphabet and how to read to solving complex math problems and reading multiple novels. From tetherball, tag, and foursquare to varsity level sports and, of course, in-depth online gaming. Today, you have reached a rite of passage as set by today's society, graduation. From this point forward, life is not sequential. It does not follow a numerical or alphabetical order. Teachers will no longer pressure you to do your best, and many of you will find yourself in a new space called adulthood. This new journey is all on you. Take charge in being self-accountable. Your ability to find success will greatly determine your ability to understand and process failure as a learning opportunity. Winners do not always win. They just fail at accepting failure. Shelter and grow your strengths while keeping an open mind and reflective approach to your weaknesses. The nuts and bolts in a capital T truth in life are usually somewhere in the middle. You are fully capable of shaping your own reality and your goals, so do not get stuck in the all too easy to find quagmire of excuses and displacing blame on others. Surround yourself with people who are successful and learn from them. Self-affirmations, as silly as they might sound, really do work. Luck is not random. It is a conscious mindset of belief. Surrender to that which is not in your control. Life is full of traps and pitfalls, so step around them. Nurture and foster healthy relationships. They are worth the investments. Faith and belief are two of the most powerful tools I have ever found. Remember to breathe, and always keep in mind how good it could be if we all stopped making it worse. Kitschy catchphrases are nearly over. Some of you are going to be going into the military services. Some of you are going to be going out into the workforce immediately. Some of you are going to go into skill-based trades and trade schools. Some of you are going to go off to college to become doctors, lawyers, and teachers. Regardless of where you are going or what you plan on becoming, remember to be kind, understanding, open-minded, honest, and loyal. But most of all, focus on being better tomorrow than you are today, and you will always find success in life and all that it has to offer. Live it, love it, life. It's what you make of it. Congratulations.
Welcome, friends, family, and fellow graduates of class of 2020. Here we are. Graduation may differ from what we anticipated, yet here we are, on the brink of unsurmounted success. It's time we move on. We've turned in our last assignment, taken our last test, gone to our last game, gone to our last class. We've had our last breakdown at finals, we've closed our locker doors one last time. We told each other, see you soon, with that very intention. We knew we'd be back to the place where it began. Here we are, clad in cap and gown, ready to further impact history. We will close the doors to Hidden Valley High School one last time. Close this chapter of the Book of Life. Here we are to say our goodbyes and start our new lives. We didn't get a senior prom, didn't get to compete in class Olympics, didn't get to camp out together, didn't have a senior prank, didn't get to celebrate our events, play our spring sports, and aren't having the traditional graduation we've been expecting. While those activities were nothing short of unifying, we genuinely didn't need them. All we needed was each other. You'll never know the value of a moment until it becomes a memory, as the great monumental Dr. Seuss once said. We decided this was our class quote long before we could have predicted where our future held so firmly. Every spirit assembly, late night rivalry game, team huddle, spirit week, dance, blood drive, assembly of recognition, concert, play, fashion show, and noise parade, we've been making memories that will never die all along. The graduating class of 2020 will not be remembered for its academic achievements, the events we had, or our athletics. We'll be remembered for our spirit. We've always been this kind of trial class. Let's see how far we can push them. We've turned disadvantages into virtues. Why would we be invested in privileges that are no longer? We're better than that. We, as a class, have been exposed to several new experiences that other classes will not have the opportunity to endure. This is the perfect example of grievances that make us more optimistic. It's time to focus now on what we're here to pursue in the world. With arms open wide, we embrace the newfound space to express individuality. There is nothing we cannot handle. Not now, nor ever. We are the graduating class of 2020, and I challenge you to give us an obstacle we can't manage. I dare you to put something in front of us. You can take our time, you can take our activities, you can take our memories, but you will never take our spirit. We are an invincible force. There is strength and unity, and we are united. We are the future. Congratulations, class of 2020.
My name is Brenna Baer, and I'm the ASB president at Hidden Valley High School. I would like to thank our superintendent, Dave Valenzuela, and our school board, board chair, Rich Halstead, vice chair, Jennifer Johnson, board member, Danny York, board member, Kate Dwyer, and board member, Paul Kelly. I would also like to thank the Hidden Valley High School administration, principal, Damian Croson, assistant principals, Brian Miller and Rachel Damiano, and the rest of the staff at Hidden Valley High School. We couldn't have done it without your continued support of each and every one of us. I would like to leave my graduating class with a reminder that Hannah Montana once said, "You can change your hair and you can change your clothes. You can change your mind. That's just the way it goes. You can say goodbye and you can say hello, but you'll always find your way back home." I would now like to introduce the valedictorians, Daniel Beachy and Alex O'Sullivan, and the salutatorians, Sierra Combe, Joseph Gerson, and Ethan Schaefer.
A couple weeks ago, I was sitting in my room debating over what I should say. I came up with many different speeches that said many various things. However, none of them seemed quite right. And then I got some advice from several different seniors about what I should say. After much deliberation, we came up with taking quotes from our childhood movies and TV shows and stringing them together. This is what we came up with. So no one ever told you life was going to be this way. Sometimes you try your hardest, but things don't turn out the way you want them to. Sometimes things have to change, and maybe sometimes they're for the better. It's not until you lose everything that you truly appreciate everything. To persevere, I think, is important for everybody. Don't give up, don't give in. There's always an answer to everything. You are a unique person created for a special purpose. Your gifts matter, your dreams matter, your stories matter. You matter. Miracles happen every day. Some people don't think so, but they do. A shining new era is tiptoeing near. Today's special moments are tomorrow's memories. Telling stories and laughing with friends, precious moments you'll never forget. We didn't realize we were making memories. We just knew we were having fun. Happiness is the richest thing we can own. Happiness can be found even in the darkest of times if only one remembers to turn on the light. And if you're scared, just be scarier than whatever is scaring you. Adventure is out there. To live is an awfully big adventure. Sometimes the right path is not the easiest one. Let your heart guide you. It whispers, so listen closely. Goodbye? Oh no, please. Can't we just go back to page one and start all over again? As you wish. The only way to get what you want in this world is through hard work. Have faith in your dreams, and someday your rainbow will come shining through. The very things that hold you down are going to lift you up. Just keep swimming. Even miracles take a little time. Hakuna Matata. It means no worries for the rest of your days. Make my way downtown, walking fast, faces pass, and you're homebound. It's like the sky is new. Well, that's the good part, I guess. It's like you get a new dream. You're never too old to be young. A true hero isn't measured by the size of his strength, but by the size of his heart. You're mad bonkers off your head, but I'll tell you a secret. All the best people are. You're killing me, Smalls, but we're all right. That's all, folks.
Greetings, class of 2020. Today marks the end of an important period in our lives. During our stay at Hidden Valley, we have all accrued stories that are just as special to us as the people they belong to. Our unique staff and student body has given us all a high school experience that we will never forget. However, our high school years are coming to a close, but our journey into life has only just begun. By graduating, we have all been given the opportunity to succeed, but it's up to you now to decide how it ends up. We can now try to become the best at our craft, we can try to reach our aspirations, or we can do what we love. So as this chapter in our lives concludes, it is with great certainty that the future is ours for the taking. And although we are not together in these final moments, remember that we will always be the class of 2020.
Dear fellow students, this is the final frontier. Now the end is near. And so as we face the final curtain here at Hidden Valley, I wanted to reflect upon the journey and what I have learned along the way. In doing so, I came to realize that what I felt most was gratitude. Gratitude for the community that Hidden Valley High School is, the entire class of 2020. We developed a critical camaraderie amongst each other these last 4 years, something I genuinely appreciate and love. Gratitude for the friendships I've made. Ben Clark and Jose Lopez, my best friends since middle school. I cannot think of my years at Hidden Valley without thinking of these two people. Gratitude for the teachers and staff of Hidden Valley. You guys helped me grow more than just academically. A special thanks to Mr. Bass for connecting with me as a person and helping me enjoy something I never thought I would ever enjoy. Mrs. Bars for showing that learning could be an enjoyable experience. The potlucks really helped. Mr. Powers for keeping me accountable and enlightening me on the joy of mathletes. Mrs. Wright for being a chill person and helping me foster my hyper-American patriot personality. God bless. Mr. Pendleton for teaching me how to prioritize and helping this introverted nerd develop his speech skills. I wouldn't be able to be here talking to you guys with otherwise. Mr. Farmer, for supporting my AP physics pursuits even though it was way above the call of duty. Miss Wilson, controversies aside, for making me discover my drive to learn and study materials entirely on my own. Gratitude for my family, for keeping me oriented, for showing me what is truly important and what to fight for. I look forward to the opportunities that lie ahead. We, the class of 2020, have made these 4 years our own. We did it our way. Yes, there was times, I'm sure you knew, when we bit off a bit more than we could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, we ate it up and spat it out. We faced it all, and we stood tall. We did it our way. So I am grateful. I know not what the future has in store for us, but we will persevere. So go forward, class of 2020. Go boldly forward where no one has gone before.
Dear friends, families, faculty, and fellow graduates, we did it. The moment we have been waiting for has finally come, and yet it looks nothing like we have ever imagined. It was just 3 months ago when we were normal high school seniors. Friday, March 13th, was the day that our normal senior year was completely turned around. At first, we thought school would be back in just a couple weeks. Little did we know, that was our last day of high school, ever. Prom, scholarship night, even entire sports seasons were canceled just like that. To say the least, missing out on all of our senior year activities has been disappointing to us all. However, through this experience, each and every one of us has taken away a very valuable lesson. Don't take things for granted. We have all learned the importance of living life in the present and cherishing every experience. I can still recall something that Mr. Stone said during one of his many long speeches our freshman year. He told us that high school would fly by and reminded us to enjoy it while it lasted. Many of us, including myself, disregarded the advice. Graduation seemed like a decade away, and we only wanted high school to go by faster. Now, after completing 4 years of high school, I can say he was absolutely correct. Time flew. While our senior year didn't end up as we hoped it would, I am still grateful for all the experiences we did get from Hidden Valley. The Friday night football games, school dances, and spirit assemblies are all things that made for an amazing high school experience. So while we could focus on everything the coronavirus took from us, let's instead be grateful for the many things we did get to experience. I would also like to take this time to thank the many people who have helped us reach this point in life. Firstly, I would like to thank my parents, who have been instrumental in my own success. Thank you for showing me your endless love and support no matter what. Most of us would not have made it to this point without the guidance of our parents and loved ones. So please, take the time to thank your parents and loved ones for all they have done for you. Next, I thank all the teachers I have had at Hidden Valley. You guys have had such an impact on each and every one of us seniors. You have taught us so much more than just English, math, or science. You have been there for us each step of the way, and I am so grateful for that. Lastly, thank you to all of the administrators for making an effort to properly recognize the class of 2020 given the circumstances. Finally, I would like to leave you with a little bit of hope for our current situation. The uncertainty surrounding us can feel very heavy at times. Those of us heading off to college may not get the opportunity to step onto campus this fall. Those of us entering directly into the workforce may have worries about being able to find a job amidst the economic impact of the virus. While we cannot control COVID-19, we can control our actions and attitude toward our situation. If we take this opportunity to focus less on ourselves and focus instead on loving and supporting the people around us, we will have a much easier time getting through the pandemic. Instead of focusing on everything the virus has taken from us, let's instead focus on the great things to come. Because one thing is for certain, together we will get through this. I am truly honored to be a part of this graduating class. We have worked so hard to get here, and it has finally paid off. Congratulations, class of 2020. And for one last time, go Stangs.